Hi everybody, today is May 15th, 2013. I don't know if I should laugh or I should just get mad about this. Undocumented immigrant barred from meeting Obama fights and he actually wins. As soon as he entered Manor New Tech High School on Thursday, Francisco Martinez said the principal spotted him and took him to the last place they expected to go that day, the classroom President Barack Obama planned to visit. Martinez, an 18-year-old senior at Manor New Tech, said he was selected on Monday to be one of the few students to present their school projects to the president. However, when he told his teacher he did not have a passport and had come to the country illegally, Martinez said he was told he could not be present. Officials would not confirm nor deny Martinez's explanation about why he was told he would not be allowed in. Manor school district officials said the White House coordinated all aspects of the president's visit. The White House did not return calls for comment. Angry that he was being excluded, Martinez took his story to the internet. He and his friends started petitions on the White House website explaining his situation and asked Obama to step in. They shared it on Facebook. By revealing he had come to this country illegally when he was 10 years old, Martinez knew he had opened the door to possible legal repercussions, including deportation. He tried not to worry about it. For a little while, I was afraid, he said, but then I talked to different people, and they said, "You're going to be all right. We've got your back. You have the whole nation behind you." And then those fears just went away. In a letter posted online Wednesday in the Blackland Reporter, a newspaper in Manor, Martinez wrote, "I am an undocumented student who was brought here from Mexico 8 years ago. Although I've done everything right so far to meet you, I still can't. I understand the security concerns, but I'm not a security threat." As Obama's trip to Austin drew near, Martinez's story was repeated and spread by local media and national immigration advocates. Then, first thing Thursday, the principal took him to the classroom, where a nervous Martinez hugged his teacher and awaited the rest of the class for the president's arrival. Martinez said he never got an explanation of whose mind had changed or why. He didn't need one. Martinez said he came to the U.S. from Mexico when he was 10 years old after the death of his mother. His father abandoned the family when he was born, he said. He lives with and is supported by his brother and sister, who are also undocumented, Martinez said. Dennis Gilman, a UT law professor and co-director of the school's immigration clinic, said Martinez's biggest shield from deportation is sharing his story. The federal government is less likely to take action against people who have received public attention, she said. Walter Tredro, the vice president of UT University Leadership Initiative, a student organization that advocates amnesty for student immigrants, said he tried to get people to sign the White House petition and support Martinez. Tredro said the fact that Martinez might not have been allowed to make a presentation to the president worries him. "I don't think the image that people have that undocumented people are criminals is right," Tredro said. "Incidents like this really feed the image that people in society have about undocumented students." Martinez said he is hoping to attend the University of Houston to study architecture and science. He has 26 college credit hours and is going to apply for deferred action after he graduates. He hopes to join the military. "What makes me mad is undocumented illegal immigrants coming to the United States and taking our jobs. There is a woman who works, or who I worked with, at a hotel who got more hours than me, and she is an undocumented worker. Every time someone tried to do something about it, she claimed discrimination. So my hours were cut to about 4 hours a week while she worked full-time. Now you tell me that's fair." So now I'm working as a cook, but I'm getting at least 10 hours a week now. And I guess 10 hours a week is better than 4. That woman is still making more money and more hours than me, and I'm an American citizen, born and raised here in the United States. I never got the chance to go to college, etc. And at 59 years old, I think it's a little too late. All right, well, bookmark my site. I'll keep you up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.